I think it's interesting with some of the really iconic, successful people out there. They were never the natural, brilliant people. They were often the underdog. The truth is, I don't have a lot of self-confidence, and I never really had much self-belief either. But I think we can draw strength from our weaknesses, that it's okay to not feel super confident. So I'd really reach out to young people who are the unseen and the unsung and the uncelebrated. I often say that the people who do so well in life have had a real dogged battle at school. They never got any prizes, they never got into the top teams, they never got the A's. Just to stay afloat, they were swimming so frantically, trying to kick for the shore, and all the people at school think, look, there's Johnny still kicking, and they laugh. But the thing is, when they hit life and they get out of that sea, everyone else is flabby because they've never had a try. Johnny, he's been kicking like madness every year. Nobody's ever noticed him until he gets out, and they realize, wow. So really, for me, the only muscle you need to develop is your effort muscle. And the harder you try and the more you practice, you're going to be ready for life. And really, that's how you empower people. I never really had any career aspirations as a young kid. All I wanted to do was climb trees and get muddy. I was never particularly brilliant at sports or academics or stuff at school, and I think I knew that I loved adventure. I loved to be close to my dad. I knew that I was gaining skills accidentally through the adventures we were doing, and the army was a natural kind of progression of those things. And I kind of heard my dad when he said, just try in life to work out of your core competency, and it's okay to follow your heart. Well, I think you do this step at a time, inch by inch, and you try and stay true to the vision. For me, my goal was simple. One is that one day I really dreamt of being able to stand on the roof of the world on the summit of Everest. But then life comes along and hits us sideways with something unexpected. Then you really see what people are made of. And for me, that time came when I had my parachuting accident whilst I was serving in the military, and I broke my back in three places and spent, you know, months in and out of, you know, hospitals, and suddenly, like, now all bets are off. How are you gonna rebuild it from here? And the truth is, I struggled with confidence and I struggled a lot with self-doubt, but I was dogged and I was determined. So really, for me, the real summit, metaphorical and emotional and physical and everything, was rebuilding from there and having the tenacity to try and keep going. The important thing, number one, you gotta have a dream. Number two, you've got to not listen to the dream stealers, the people who will tell you you're crazy, tell you're mad. Because the world doesn't like people who kind of actually get out there and make things happen. And in a way, the world is just testing you. It's saying, are these just words out of your lips, or do you really mean it? From there, it's also important to paddle your own canoe, you know, choose your own path. You know, it's, don't expect the world to give it to you. You're gonna have to do this yourself. Then I think it's, you got to be ready for failure. It's the only way you can get somewhere meaningful. The only way you're gonna get to your dream, to your goal, is through the door of failure. There are no back doors to it. There's only one main door. You've got to go through it. And you might have to fail a ton of times, but you've got to fail. So then after failure, there's some values to carry along this road with you. And I say two of them, courage and kindness. Kindness is a really important one, you know, otherwise you just become one of these ambitious people who kind of kicks everyone out of the way and nobody likes you. And if at the end of your life you've got no good relationships, you're not a successful person. And real courage is facing things that we're all scared of. And I've never yet met anyone in this life who's not scared of stuff. But the thing is, I've learned about facing fears and courage is that the best way over our fears is actually right through the middle. If you're gonna be ambitious and you're gonna go for big obstacles, you really need to learn how to face the giants. And what happens when we walk straight towards the big giants is that we often realize they're not as scary as they seem, and often they actually totally evaporate. Ultimately, the only thing that really matters is that spirit of endeavor, of never giving up. It's having the courage to follow what is really on your heart and what you feel you're naturally good at and you naturally love. Be tenacious, be dogged, be determined, never give up. There is a power to those words. I say it to my boys every day, N-G-U, N-G-U, never give up.